preparation for online test. Okay, let's revise some of the questions to you. We may revise whether which is correct or not. Coming to that, what we are going to talk about, the planet with a single satellite, with a single satellite going around it. To talk about that, see here, Earth and Mercury. And coming to that, Venus. And fourth option is Mars. And let's talk about one more. The stars forming a recognizable shape is called to talk about the constellation and asteroids and system galaxy. Our option is system and fourth option is galaxy. And coming to that, the planet on which the duration of the day or of day and night is, and night is almost the same as on the earth. To talk about that, so we'll go with Saturn and Mars. And coming to that, next, Uranus. And fourth one is Jupiter. And coming to talk about one more, which unit used to measure astronomical distance. Then coming to talk about that, sound year, and fourth one is leap year. The next thing is, which of the following planet is known to be without a satellite. To talk about that, Neptune, Earth, and Mercury, and fourth one is Mars. See that? What we are saying about that? Is it visible to you? Yes. Yeah. The planet with a single satellite going around it, Mars. See here? The planet with a single satellite means the planet which is having a single satellite means only one satellite. What we learn about before in that? There are different satellites for different planets. Means there are number of planets for number of satellites for number of planets. But what about there is only one satellite for the planet? Only one natural satellite or only one moon? Which is that? See here, Venus has no satellite or natural satellite. Which is the first planet in our solar system from the sun? Can you? Which is that first planet that is nothing as a Mercury? Mercury is the first planet in our solar system from the sun. So the Mercury has no natural satellite, or Mercury has no any one of the moon to rotate in its own axis. So Mercury is not suitable to talk about. Mercury is not suitable to talk about what? A single satellite. And of course, Venus also is not, what we can say, Venus also is not, means Venus is a second planet from the sun in our solar system. Of course, Venus also have no or has no natural satellite, means it is also have no any moon to rotate in one axis. So we can consider, so Mercury and Venus has no natural satellite. Understand? Mars has two satellites, two natural satellites. We already discussed those. What about the names also? So Mars also is not suitable to pass to single natural satellite or single moon to around the planet. So coming to the remain one is Earth. Mercury has no satellite. Venus also has no satellite. Mars are having two natural satellites. Then what about Earth? Earth having only one natural satellite. That is nothing as, of course, we can say moon. In a general language, we can call Chandamama. See here, what we can say, Chandrudu. Okay, Earth has only one natural satellite. It revolves around the Earth. The natural satellite is revolving around the Earth. That we can call in our general language moon. So Earth has only one, what a natural satellite. Okay. The planet with a single satellite going around it. So that nothing as Earth. Coming to that, the stars forming recognizable shape. What we can say, the stars are forming a recognizable shape. What we call that? Galaxy means, we say, the group of stars include the planet. So it is not as possible to talk. It is not a system to talk about that. Is it or not? And asteroid, what we discussed, it is a part of rock substance. Those are placed where the space between Jupiter and Mars around orbit. Understand? So what we can say, asteroids also is not suitable to talk, a stars forming recognizable shape. Because asteroid is not a star. Then constellation is a group of stars. Constellation is a group of stars to recognizable a particular shape. So how is it suitable for that water? Constellation. Understand? Coming to that, the planet on which the duration of day and night is almost the same as on the Earth. Did you understand what is the question clearly? the planet on which the duration of day, the day duration, generally on the surface of Earth, duration of day, the timing of day is 24 hours. They are saying to us, during the day and night, means duration of day and night is almost the same as on the Earth. The planet which is having same duration of day and night, similar to the surface of Earth. Those concepts they given to us, Saturn, Mars, Uranus, Jupiter. Remember here, Uranus, Jupiter, Saturn. These three planets are, those three planets are outermost planets in our solar system. Means outer planets in our solar system from the sun. Because they are very far from the sun. They are very far from the sun. What are those? See, Uranus, Jupiter, Saturn. And also one more there, Neptune. Those will rotate very slowly. Those will revolve around the sun also very slowly. So by that, what we can consider, the duration of day and night is more, much more than to the Earth's surface. So Mars is the inner planet in our solar system from the sun. And also it is very near to the water, Earth's surface than to the Venus. So that's why Mars has a similar duration for day and night as Earth. So what we can consider? Mars. Which unit is used to measure astronomical distance? Which unit used to measure astronomical distance? What is the astronomical distance? What is the mean of astronomical distance? Means the distance between any of the celestial bodies in our solar system. The distance between any distance means the distance between any of the heavenly bodies. Suppose we said the distance between Earth to Sun, how much we consider 150 million kilometers around. So the distance should measure because Earth and Sun is a celestial body in our solar system, in our universe. The distance between means we have to use the unit to measure the distance between any celestial body or heavenly body. Okay? So those units, what is that unit to measure astronomical distance? So century. Century means 100. Century means 100. It's not a measurable unit to utilize the astronomical distance. And sound year, if there is no such a type of unit to measure. And leap year, it consists of on the surface of Earth, the duration of year of every 4 years, 366, while the Earth revolves around the sun. And coming to that light year, the light year, the light travels throughout the year in our universe. How much distance it travels, that we can call one light year. One light year. Light year is the unit to measure the astronomical distance. Light year is the unit to measure the astronomical distance. The next thing is, what is that? Which of the following planet is known to be without a satellite? What we can consider? Which of the following planet is known to be without a satellite? Tell you answer. Which planet has no natural satellite or moon? Before we already learned about that, Mercury and Venus have no natural satellite. Is it or not? Of course. Then what about? See here, Neptune, Earth, Mercury, Mars. So Mercury has no water? Satellite. Mercury has no satellite or natural satellite. Note on that. Make it right first.
Yeah, coming to that.
Name of the planet. Name of the planet. And compare meter, diameter. What we can say? Compare it to diameter with the diameter of Earth. Diameter with the diameter of Earth. Coming to that, distance from the sun, distance from the sun, distance from the sun in crore kilometers, period of revolution, distance from the sun in crore kilometers, period of revolution, period of revolution. And coming to that, what we can say, number of satellites. Number of satellites. So let's talk about Mercury. Mercury 0.38. 0.38, 5.79, 88 days, and zero number of satellites. And coming to that next, Venus. And coming to that, 0.95. 10.8, and 225 days, and zero. Next, Earth. Earth we will compare with one, and 15, and coming to that, 365 days. 365 days and one number of natural satellites. Next, Mars. Mars. So 0.53 and 687 days, and it has two number of satellites. And Jupiter, Jupiter having 11.19, and what we can say 77.8, 12 years 50. The next thing is Saturn 9.40, 142.7, 29.5 years, 53. And the next what we can write, Uranus 4.04, 4.04, 286.9, 284 years, 27. And last, Neptune 3.88 and 449.7, 165 years, 13. The number of satellites are declared so far. What we can say? Coming to that, see here we are giving a brief information about each and every planet. Name of the planets goes, what are those? Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune. And compare the diameter with the diameter of Earth. What is the diameter of the Earth? We are comparing to equal 1. Compared to that, Mercury has 0.38. It is very small in our solar system. Next smallest, which is this, see here, Mars is the next smallest, means Mars is smaller than to the Uranus, Venus. Mars is smaller than to the Venus because it is much smaller, means slightly greater than to the Mercury, smaller than to the Venus according to the diameter. And coming to that, Jupiter, diameter 11.19. Compared to Earth, it is greater, 10 times greater than Earth. Saturn 9.40, Uranus 4.04, Neptune 3.88. So these planets, outer planets, are greater than our Earth. From the inner planet, Earth only heavier objects are greater objects, big objects. Distance from the Sun in cross kilometers. Distance from the Sun. Mercury is at 5.79 crore kilometers, means 5.794 kilometers. And coming to that, Venus 10.8 crore kilometers, and then Earth 15 crore kilometers, Mars 22.8 crore kilometers. Jupiter 77.8 crore kilometers. Observe there, from Jupiter, Saturn, Uranus, Neptune, they are very, very far from the Sun. Okay, compared to those, these distances are related to the revolution, period of revolution, the planets which revolve around the Sun. So Mercury taking 88 days, and number of satellites are zero. Okay, it's so far, not it rightly what we written. And Venus taking 225 days, it is also has no natural satellite. And Earth, what about Earth? It's taking 365 days to complete one revolve around the Sun. It has only one natural satellite. Mars taking 687 days to complete one revolve around the Sun. Means, so to finish what a revolution by the Mars around the sun. The Earth takes twice to finish revolution around the sun. It has been two natural satellites. Of course, this is our fixed. These are some of changed. Jupiter, Saturn are those. Number of satellites are changed. Jupiter and Saturn. So Saturn has a maximum number of satellites. Saturn has a maximum number of satellites around unknown. Also include that. This include known and unknown. There are around more than 70. Around more than 70. It is Jupiter satellites are around 60. It is nearby. Include known and unknown. Okay, nearby 60. So by the way, see once observe carefully. Jupiter taking 12 years compared to the Earth. Earth taking 1 year to complete one revolve. Then Jupiter taking 12 years to finish one complete revolution around the sun. Then about see compare one. This is Saturn taking 29.5 years. Means Earth should finish 29 times to finish one complete revolution by the Saturn. While Saturn finishing that complete revolution around the sun, Earth takes 29 years, 29 times revolution around the sun. And Uranus taking 84 years. Uranus taking 84 years. Imagine one. Means Earth should take 84 times to finish one revolution around the sun. Then what about last? Neptune taking 165 years. Neptune taking 165 years to finish one complete revolution. Means our Earth will finish 165 times of revolution around the sun. But by finishing Uranus and then Neptune, while Uranus and Neptune revolving around the sun, by finishing one complete revolve, whether we will believe or not, we don't know that. Will be in life or not. Is it or not? Because of that many years it is taking. This is general information about them. Write down the okay, these are earlier what they discovered those remain as the same. Number of satellites. Okay. By that we can compare, while distance is increases, the period of revolution also increases, means the speed of planet is going to decrease. The speed of planet to revolve around the sun is taking to decrease. Understand? And last one is what about Pluto. It has a number of satellites. Number of satellites are 3. Number of natural satellites are 3. But we did not learn about that. Means we are not learning about Pluto. We are learning about only 8 planets. We are learning about 8 planets. So finish that, then we'll talk about some more. Let's talk about some more. These are a part of the solar system. These are a part of the solar system. What are those? Planets and satellites. And coming to that, meteoroids. And next thing is, the nearest star from us is, the nearest star from us is, one is Sun, Polestar, Mercury, Moon. And coming to that, next thing is, the nearest planet to the Sun is, the nearest planet to the Sun is, what we can say for that? Mercury, Uranus, Earth, Venus. Coming to that, the planet which is the farthest from the Sun is, what we can say, Uranus and Mercury. Otherwise, what we can say about that, Mars, Jupiter, Neptune, Venus. Coming to the next, the planet that appears reddish in color. Reddish in color. And which can we can say reddish in color? A group of stars that appears right, a celestial body that revolve around a planet. The celestial body which revolves around the planet. is known as what we can say that the smallest planet of the solar system. The smallest planet of the solar system. What we can say, which is the smallest? The largest planet of the solar system. The largest planet of the solar system. And coming to that, which one is the giant planet? Which is known as giant planet. Which is known as giant planet. And what we can say, the number of planets in our solar system. See once, is that visible to you? Coming to that, these are a part of the solar system. What are those? Which is a part of the solar system? See, planets are in our solar system. Satellites also is in our solar system. Metro is also in the solar system. So all are the part of solar system. The nearest stars from us, you know well about Sun is a star near to the Earth. The nearest planet to the Sun is, the first planet from the Sun is a Mercury. The planet which is farthest from the Sun is very far, which is Mercury, Venus, Earth, Mars, Jupiter, Saturn, and then what we can say about Uranus, Neptune. So which is that? Neptune is the farthest planet from the Sun. The planet that appears reddish in color, which appears in reddish color, the planet is nothing else Mars. Mars appears as in reddish color. The celestial body which revolve around the planet, those we can call satellite. What we can call satellite, or we can call moon or natural satellite. The smallest planet of the solar system is nothing else, what we can say that? Mercury. Mercury is the smallest planet in our solar system. Largest planet in our solar system is nothing else, Jupiter. Which is known as giant planet, which is huge planet in our solar system, is nothing else, of course, what is that? Jupiter. The number of planets in our solar system, how many planets are there? 8 or 9 or 10. So now we are learning about only 8 planets. We are learning about only 8 planets. Okay, note on that, keep in learning. Be well practiced for your examination. See you in the next class. Have a good day to you.
Thank you.